blessed morning. Buenas noches, buenas tardes. Kasi puro Espanyol yung kinanta natin, ano? Spanish. Ang mga Pilipino kasi, ano tayo, we have been colonized for 400 years by Spain. Isn't it right? Sino sa magagaling sa history? Sa mapagpalang umaga, welcome po sa bago nating lugar. I know some of you are shocked that we went down, no? It was actually sudden. It was a move that we made. December 25, Christmas na Christmas po lahat kami naglilipat. Galing po doon church sa fourth floor, ngayon po nasa first floor na. Pero wala namang pagbabago, di ba? Copy-paste lang, no? Glory to God. Welcome po sa ating mga bagong dalo. Welcome po sa Grace Church International. Salamat po at kayo po ay aming makakasama sa pagpupuri sa ating Panginoon. Muli po ay bago po ako mag-umpisa ay nais ko pong lingunin nyo yung inyong mga katabi at sabihin mo, you are blessed this morning.
You are blessed this morning.
We are blessed.
Amen. Ano? Truly, tunay nga na sa tuwing umaga na tayo ay may buhay, isang malaking pagpapala ito mula sa Diyos. Amen. Marami pong may sakit, maraming may karamdaman, bagamat marami tayong nararamdaman sa ating mga likod, sa ating mga tuhod dahil sa paglilipat, hindi po mahirap, madali pa lang maglipat ng isang araw. Imagine from 12 to 12, 12 hours, dire-direcho, kain lang ang pahinga. But praise and glory to God. Siya po yung nagbigay sa atin ng kalakasan. Amen po. How beautiful and pleasant it is for brethren to dwell together in unity and harmony. Tunay na pag may pagkakaisa, no, madaling natatapos ang isang bagay. Amen po. Today I want to talk to you about growth. Growth. No, today I want to talk to you about this message in which Paul, the Apostle Paul, use an analogy of a race. Alam niyo po, ako ay sumali na sa isang takbuhan. I don't know, sino na po sa inyo ang sumali na sa marathon or a 10K run or NBK walkathon? Yan. Recently, most of the brethren sumali sila. Actually, sumali ako pero hindi ako tumakbo. Hindi ako naglakad pala, no? Kasi may pasok ako. Humuha lang ako ng damit. Humuha ako ng NBK walkathon 2018. So, actually, if I remember correctly, when I was in Shakey's, I joined actually in a marathon, which is a 10K run, no? Pero sadly, hindi ko natapos. Tumukod ako. At mostly din, sa mga nagwo-walkathon, ang finish line nila, McDonald's. No, hindi na ako maabot sa ano, kasi pagkakita ko, McDonald's, tama na yung 2K run, tama na yun. Ang finish line is McDonald's. And sadly, bakit po? There are three reasons why I did not finish the race. No? Bakit ako tumuod? Because actually, to finish the race, you have to really put effort. You push hard, you read magazine, you go on diet, you do something to achieve na yung iyong physical body ay mag-a-adapt doon sa napakahaba o napaka-gruesome na milya-milyang lalakarin o tatakbuhin mo. Do you agree with me?
Yes.
And believe me, if you are not used to running and then you will just run, believe me, after maybe 2 or 3 hours, hindi na pantay ang lakad mo. And that's the truth. May sasakit na sa kanang bahagi ng iyong binte or hita because you do not exercise. You do not prepare for it. And today, I want us to read this passage from Philippians chapter 3, verse 12 to 16. And as I told you many times or several times in the Bible, Paul uses the analogy of a race in Christian living. Ginagamit ni Paul lagi itong many of Paul's letters in the Bible, he uses the analogy of a race, yung pagtakbo, no? Yung pagtakbo, ang sabi niya rito sa 1 Corinthians 9 verses 24 to 27, I'm reading from NKJV. Do you not know that those who run in race all run, but one received the prize? Run in such a way that you may obtain it. Ayan, kita niyo yung admonish or or pagbibigay ni Paul ng letter na ito sa mga Kristiyano sa Corinth, no, mamaya na yan sis, wala ito dyan. Do you not know, sabi niya, do you not know that those who run in the race all run? Definitely. Pag nasa race ka, tumakbo ka. Ba't ka pa pumunta rin kung di ka rin lang tatakbo? Amen?
Amen. Amen.
Parang ang ginagawa ko rito, lahat sila tumatakbo na, naiwan ka. So run the race, sabi ni Paul. And not only run the race, ang sabi niya, tumakbo ka, okay? Tumakbo ka na kung saan gusto mong makamtan yung first prize. Ayan. Hindi lang kayo tatakbo rin kasi, eh, sandali, sandali. Ano yon? Selfie, no? Parang nung mga nag-walkout to, no? Sabi, ano ba kayo? Naglalakad pa kayo tuwing 1 kilometer, sandali, sandali. Selfie. Puro selfie lang. Ang sabi ni Paul, run the race in which you will obtain the prize. Ang sabi ni Paul. And everyone who competes for the prize is temperate. Listen to this. Temperate. Okay? Ano ibig sabihin ng temperate? In all things. No, kahit na nakikita mong ayan yung McDonald's. Ayan yung McDonald's. Kailangan may discipline ka. Set your eyes, focus on the finish line. Okay? You have to be temperate. Okay? Tapos ang sabi niya rito, now they do it to obtain is a perishable crown, but we for an imperishable crown. Therefore, I run thus not with uncertainty, thus I fight not as one who beats the air, but I discipline my body. Here it comes. I discipline my body. Dito na pumapasok yung diet. Eating the right food. Sleeping early. Okay, lahat to kailangan para mapag-prepare tayo doon sa takbuhin or sa race. When I have preached to others, I myself should become disqualified. So dito ganun din sinasabi niya. In our passage in Philippians chapter 12, 3 verse 12 to 16, I actually took this from NASB, New American Standard Bible. And sabi niya rito, not that I have already obtained it or have already become perfect. The word perfect here is not actually perfection but maturity. In this lifetime, we cannot achieve perfection but maturity is possible. Amen?
Amen.
And he said, but I press on. You see, Paul says, but I press on so that I may lay hold of that for which also I was laid hold of by Christ Jesus. Yan po yung mga verses na pag-aaralan natin in italic, naka-italize po yan in red. Those are the words that we are going to study this morning. Brethren, I do not regard myself as having laid hold of it yet, but one thing I do, forgetting what lies behind and reaching forward to what lies ahead. Continue in verse 14. Again, dalawang beses niyang inulit. Again, here comes that word. I press on what toward the goal. For the prize of the upward call of God in Christ Jesus, let us therefore, you see, from personal, Paul was admonishing the Christian, his personal journey, his personal race. Now he says, let us therefore, as many as are mature, again that word perfect, have this attitude. And if anything you have a different attitude, God will reveal that also to you. However, let us keep living by the same standard to which we have attained. Christianity is developing a relationship with Jesus Christ. And when God called us, He expects us to grow. Do you believe that?
Yes.
When God called us, He expects us to grow. Tayong mga tatay, nanay, kung kayo'y may anak na 1 year ago, 16, 15 years old na siya, nagpapalit pa rin kayo ng diaper, what would you feel? Diba? You expect our children to grow and to mature. Amen? The same as God, when God called us, when He saved us, He don't want us to stay in that same attitude, in that same character, in that same na ugali. He wants us to grow. Amen? And that's why today, this morning, actually this is The title of this message is Spiritual Inventory. Somehow, I changed it to Go, Grow, and Goal para po madaling matandaan. 3 G's only, not Mrs. 4G, huh? 3 G's, Go, Grow, and Goal. As I said several times in the New Testament, Paul uses the analogy of a race. In Hebrews 12:1, he says there that since we are surrounded by great cloud of witnesses, let us set aside, alisin o isang tabi, the sin that easily entangles us and run the race with perseverance that is marked for us. Ayan yung sinasabi ng Hebrews 12:1. You see the analogy again? Let us run with endurance the race that is set before us. Ito yung salita ni Paul in which Christian should go. Do you know that to grow as a Christian, you got to go in the race. You have to be in the race. When you came to know Christ and yet isolate yourself and said, anyway, nagbabasa naman ako in myself, I worship God by myself. I've heard this many times. Naririnig ko to. Maraming beses ko to naririnig sa mga Kristiyano. Anyway, nag-aaral naman akong mag-isa. But let me tell you, no one grows by himself. Amen? We need each other. The wisdom of the other person or other believer, hindi mo pwedeng lahat alamin mo by yourself. We need each other. Even Paul himself admonished that bear one another. Even the Bible in Proverbs says that iron sharpens iron. And therefore, you cannot be yourself. You cannot grow by yourself. And that's why, number one, to grow as a Christian, you got to go and be in the race. You have to grow in character. Hindi nga mababago. Talagang ito ako eh. Ito yung background ko. Yung magulo ang family namin. Talagang mga chahin ko, ang almusal namin is... alam mo na, mga flying words. No? Kaya ito na ako. Hindi mo na ako mababago. But it's not. We have to grow in character and give it proper effort to reach your goal. Alam niyo yung kasabihan, let God and let go. No? It is all God who will do to change me. No? It's a lie. We have to do something to change. Amen? Yes, may kasabihan tayo, nasa Diyos ang awa, pero nasa tao ang gawa. Amen po ba? Yes. Amen. Number one point I want to discuss with you. I have only 3 points in this passage in which Paul admonished us to run the race. To grow as a Christian, you've got to go and be in the race. It's obvious, right? As I told you. You have to be in the race. When Christ called you, He put you in the race, then He expect you to run that race. But there are many people trying to run the race that they never join. Alam nyo, maraming talagang sumasali, pero mali pala yung kanilang na-registeran. Have you been in that place? Ay, may pila ron. Nakipila ka. Yan yata yun. Yan yata yung sinalihan ko. Nakipila, no? Nakipila si Juan. Nakipila. No? Nilista pa yung pangalan. Pangalan! Juan Tamad. Saan mapapunta to? Muntinlupa. Hindi mo alam, papunta. Napunta ka tuloy sa jail. No? Mali yung sinalihan. There are many people who is running, trying to be good. You know, doing what is, that's nothing wrong with that. No? Doing what is right in their eyes. No? Katulad ng mga Israelites nung panahon ng judges, they do what they think, what is right in their eyes, thinking that this is what pleases God. But you know what? Even Paul himself in Philippians chapter 3, verse 4 to 6, in the same chapter, do you know he said in Philippians that he thought that he was running for God. He thought he was doing godly things when he was persecuting the Christian. He says in Philippians chapter 3, verse 4 to 6, prior to this passage that we just have read, he said, though I also might have confidence in the flesh, if anyone else thinks that he may have confidence in the flesh, I more so. And sabi ni Paul. This is the same, NKJV. And then he continued, circumcised the eighth day of the stock of Israel, of the tribe of Benjamin, a Hebrew of Hebrews, concerning the law of Pharisees, concerning zeal, persecuting the church, concerning the righteous which is in the law, blameless. Paul was a Pharisee. He was a Jew. Pinapapatay niya, pinahuhuli niya, and even he was instrumental, as I said in my previous preaching, he was instrumental in the death of Stephen. But God, he thought that he was doing it for God. But God turned him around. You see, there are many people thinking what they are doing is for God. And even Paul, he had the same experience. But he says here, I press on in order that I may lay hold of for which also I was laid hold of by Christ Jesus. Alam niyo yung salitang laid hold dito? It's an intensified word. The word laid hold here, put this sa next slide, kapatid. It's an intensified word that means to apprehend or seize something after a pursuit. Alam niyo yung pag ang pulis may hinuhuling magnanakaw, yung chase, at pag to'y nahuli niya, poposasan niya, kukunin niya yung dalawang kamay, talagay sa likod at poposasan niya. Ito yung sinasabi ni Paul, Christ seized me, capture me. On his way to Damascus, Paul's mission was to capture all Christians. But Jesus Christ, in a blinding light, spoke to him. That's why, ang sabi ni Paul, Christ laid hold of me, seized me. And he turned my life around. I thought I was running the right race, but I was wrong. And there are many people who think that they are doing these things for God. They're even blowing up themselves, and they said that when they die, they will meet, I don't know how many virgins, 70. You know, in 70. Heaven.
70.
70. No? Imagine this logic, this thinking. They are thinking that they are doing this for God. But let me remind you again, as I said, make sure you are in the right race. Look at your neighbor and said, and ask him, are you in the right race?
Are you in the right race?
The same idea is reflected in verse 14. Paul says, the upward call of God in Christ Jesus. God almost always referred to his effectual calling. And his calling is irrevocable, the Bible says. His calling to his elect and to salvation. We are saved because God called us to salvation. He chose us. He handpicked us from the billions of people in the world. Amen? Do you know? Napakaraming tao. More than 7 billion in the world. And God has handpicked you and chose you to be in a race. To use the sport analogy of a basketball, I know most of you can relate. If your coach calls you and says, come, play for me. I want you, yung magaling nilang umi-score, wherever he goes, sundan mo. No, yan ang coach, no, yan yung... Kahit saan siya pumunta, nasa gilid na siya, nasa labas na siya ng court, sundan mo siya. This is what actually Jesus was telling, or Paul was telling to the Christians in the church of Philippi. Ganun din naman yung kanyang pagkatawag, nung siya'y tawagin ng Panginoon, he cannot go anymore to his own ways or his own thinking. He has to turn. This means that no Christian is his own person. Amen? Pag sinabi ng Panginoon, go there, you must go there. When the Lord says, no compromise, even though mahirap, alam niyo ba yung paglipat dito? Hindi naman tayo dapat lilipat eh. We can not move a single finger if we want to. But because also they have given us favor, we want to return the favor. Yung may-ari po ng fourth floor, para po wala nang magtanong, no? Dito ko na lang po sasabihin. Kasi mahirap po lagi magtatanong, bakit kayo napaalis doon? Nag-ingay ba kayo ron? Ano ba, nagalit ba ang mga kapitbahay nyo? Hindi po. Umalis po tayo doon para po tulungan yung may-ari ng flat na yon. Kasi po itong building na to, iba-iba po ang may-ari nito. Para po condominium ito, parang sa atin. Okay? At nakiusap po yung building administrator na si Michael Milad, an Egyptian Christian, he said, please do this favor to us. can you move to the first floor? At sabi ko, it's going to be Christmas, magmubuhat kami, magmumove kami. Okay, there is another option, ang sabi niya. The Kuwaiti lady, can she stay for 2 days, 25 and 26? Imagine again. And then may darating from the government and will check na nandun siya para hindi maputol yung kanyang sustento from the government. Sa kagustuhan nating tumulong, okay, bagamat mahirap, sabi namin, parang mahirap pa. Parang saan kami pupunta? Wala kami mga pasok nung lalabas kaming lahat. Yung mga gamit namin. No, there is another option. He said, I will make you a new contract and just sign. And if somebody asks you, how long have you been there? Tell 3 months only. Sabi ko kay Michael, I cannot lie. We cannot lie. If somebody will ask us, we will tell that we are here 7 months. So he said, well, I'll just make a contract. At sabi ko naman, no, sabi ko, well, mas practical yata yung sa contract na lang. Pero pag may nagtanong, sasabihin namin yung totoo. But then this is only my decision. This is not only my decision, as I said to Michael. I said, meron kaming council of elders and I have to convey this message to them. And whatever the council's decision, yung po yung masusunod. So, to cut the story short, pinaalam ko po to sa council. At sabi nila, it's good. No, maganda naman, tutulungan natin yung kwaitiya. Okay, meron siyang tatlong anak. She's a widow. But there's still compromise. Alam mo yung pipirma ka na 230, 410 lang. 410 talaga ang price nito. And then, pag may nagtanong, what if may nagtanong? So sabi ko nga, sabi ng council, di baling mahirap basta tayo ay nasa katotohanan. Amen? Amen. You know, there's only two sides in every decision that we make. We do the right decision and it's hard. Amen? It is hard, but at least you are in the right side or in the side of God. We do the easy way or the easy fix. Madali naman, pipirma ka lang, hindi ka naaalis doon sa lugar mo, but you compromise. Which one should you choose? It's better to choose kahit mahirap, at least yung conscience mo malinis. Amen? Paul was saying like this, at even times, there are times na mahirap gawin, right? Mahirap baguhin yung ating attitude, pero kailangan nating baguhin. Mahirap pag pinapupunta tayo ng Panginoon sa isang lugar. Mahirap pag sinasabi ng Panginoon, iwanan mo na yan. You are not growing in that. Leave that vice. Leave that attitude. Mahirap, pero kailangan nating gawin because we are not our own person. This means that no Christian is his own person. You belong to Jesus Christ who bought you. The reason you're in the race is because Christ grabbed you and said, I want you to run for me. I want you to leave all those behind na nagpapabigat para tumakbo. Alam niyo yung mga runner? Alam niyo ano ba yung ginagamit? Ba yung manipis na manipis lang? Yung halos, ano na, citro na? Kasi they want light, no? Pag tumatakbo ka, dapat wala nang maraming baggages. No? Meron kasi, nagpapalusot pa eh. No? Tumatakbo naman ako eh. Okay lang na maraming dala kasi sasakay naman ako afterwards. Jesus wants us our full commitment. God does not want our casual involvement. He wants our total and intentional commitment to run the race. Amen? Ito yung, kaya ito, dito nagkakaroon ng kaibahan ang manok at ang pig. Eh. When somebody asks for a hen to give something, the hen can give an egg and still lives. Right? But if you ask a ham from a pig, sabi, paputol nga, patapyas nga sa pigi mo. Hindi pwede, di ba? Kailangan patayin mo yung baboy para maibigay niya yung ham, yung kanyang pork. It's the same thing what God wants for us when He grabbed us, when He called us. We kill or we deny ourselves daily. That's the word of the Lord Jesus Christ. Deny yourself daily. If you want to follow me, deny yourself daily. There's a difference between interest and commitment. When you're interested in doing something, you do it only when it's convenient. That's true. Diba? Interesado ako dyan. Okay yung mga ginagawa nyo. Ah, I'm interested in that. Okay, but I'm interested in that. But when you're committed to something, you accept no excuses, only results. Tsaka na akong sasama, malamig ngayon eh. Pag mainit na lang. Pagka nag-summer na. Tsaka na ako tatakbo pagka ano na, pagka summer, lamig eh. No? Tapos pag lumamig na, at saka na ako tatakbo kasi mainit eh. Lagi may excuse. But when a person is committed to slim or to be slim, kahit mainit yan, kahit malamig yan, tatakbo yan. Amen? No excuses, only result. Christian growth is a process that stems from definite awareness of being apprehended by Christ Jesus. Dapat nandito sa mentality natin, tinawag ako ng Panginoon to be in a race and I will continue to run the race. Any athlete will tell you the attitude and the difference between victory and defeat. Alam nyo ba? Hindi naman dahil sa magaling ka eh, mananalo ka. No, it's not. If you know the story of the movie Miracle, this really happens. Coach Brooks, you know the movie Miracle, 1980, a hockey team. The Russian hockey team were Olympic champions from 1964 to 1976. Imagine, they are unbeatable. Walang makatalo sa kanila. Pinadala na ng US yung kanilang mga professional national hockey players. Pero pinaglaruan lang sila ng Soviet Union. Imagine, walang tumatalo sa kanila sa Olympics. Pinadala nila yung pinakamagagaling ng mga player nila. Walang tumalo sa kanila. And then Kelly Brooks have this mind, have this mentality. He chooses NCAA players. Nagpinili niya, hinandpick niya, nagpatawag siya ng tryout. Hundreds came from different schools, NCAA, amateurs. And then he handpicked, he chose. And you know, that's why the movie is Miracle. He never looked at their talent, but then he looked at the attitude of every player and every position that he built. And true enough, they beat Soviet Union. You see, it's not about draw talent. You cannot, pwede kang hindi maging magaling sa isang bagay, but if you put your attitude, you put your best, you know, you will win. Amen?
Right.
You will win.
Amen.
As long as you put yourself, you put your mentality, you put your thinking, you put your mind into it. The Greek word translated to think or be minded in verse 15, it says here, have this attitude is used 10 times. Alam nyo ba, 10 beses? Dito lang sa napaka-iksing book na ito. 10 times ang sabi ni Paul, have this attitude, press on toward the goal. Have this mentality, have this perspective. Philippians is about joy. The book of Philippians is about joy. There's a definite correlation between attitude and joy. Two strands of Paul's attitude come through in this verse. His view Christian growth as a lifelong process. So has Paul has a long haul attitude. Alam ni Paul, nung siya'y tinawag ng Panginoon, it was not all smooth sailing. It is a long journey. It is a long, it's not a 100 meter dash, mga kapatid. When God called us in this life, hindi ito 100 meter and then that's it, you quit. No, it's not. This is a long haul attitude. There are three things I want to discuss to you about this. When Paul says that I have not arrived yet, I keep on moving ahead. He had this mentality of a long haul attitude. Christian growth is a lifelong process. Do you believe that? Christian growth is a long process. We are being changed by God from glory to glory. Hindi naman noong nakakilala ka sa Panginoon ay talagang lahat ay talagang masasabi mong nabago sa iyo. Unti-unti, from glory to glory, day by day, God changes us. Paul had been converted for the last 25 years when he wrote this book to the Philippian church. There's no question that Paul is one of the most outstanding believer. Pero anong mentality ni Paul? You know, Paul have many visions from the Lord. Inakyat siya sa third heaven na kung saan doon pinakita ng Panginoon yung langit, yung mangyayari. And he said, no eye has seen, no ear has heard what God has in store for us. But yet, tingnan niyo yung ugali ni Paul. He said, I have not arrived or I have not obtained it yet. Patuloy at patuloy siyang nagmumove forward. Sabi niya, not that I have already obtained it in verse 12. Meaning, I have not yet come to know the full knowledge of Christ's power and resurrection in my life. Ganun po ba tayo? Are we actively involved? Are we actively involved ba? Masasabi natin yung ating growth? nagbibigay ba tayo ng effort or we just go with the flow? On Friday, oh, it's Friday, I go to church. Okay, and then Saturday, Sunday, what do? Do you go back to the things you do? You don't even make an effort to grow in Christ by reading the Word of God, reading the Bible daily, meditation, prayer. This is Paul here that I press on. Sabi ko nga kanina, twice he repeated this in verse 12 and 14. The word literally means to pursue by the way of extension. Yung sinasabing hindi mo maabot, yung parang andyan lang sa shelf and yet you are, merong hindrance and yet you want to reach for that. Yun yung sinasabi ni Paul. He wants to reach for that goal, for that prize. Christian life, as I tell you, is not a 100-meter dash. It's a marathon. You need mentality of a long-distance runner if you're going to make it. You know why many Christians quit? Alam niyo kung bakit maraming Kristiyanong tumitigil at humihinto? They get tired. Napagsabihan lang ng kapatid, may nakita lang na hindi maganda, napagsabihan lang ng pastor, hindi na nag-church. They quit. Many Christians quit because they don't have this mentality of pressing forward. Life is not a 100-meter dash. Let me repeat that. It is a lifelong marathon. This attitude of viewing Christian growth as a lifelong process is crucial for at least two reasons. First reason, we all have a human tendency to want quick fixes and easy answers to difficult problems. That is true, no? Pag may mga problema tayo, no, magpa-pray ka lang sa pastor, tanggal lahat yung problema mo. Pinagpipray ka lang ng speaking in tongues, sabara ka, chigara ka. Okay, umalis ka na. You feel may mga goosebumps nga ako. Pastor, okay na ako. I'm delivered from this problem. No, it doesn't work that way. Hindi ganun kadali, mawawala ang problema mo. You have to do something. Secondly, ang sabi, secondly, it enable us to be gracious and patient with one another. Pag meron tayo kasing long-hold attitude, that it is a process, alam nyo, nagiging matyaga tayo sa lahat ng bagay. Amen? Nagiging matyaga tayo even to the other believer, to the other person. Nagiging matyaga tayo kahit makulit. Kahit minsan lagi ka nasasaktan sa kanya mga biro, nagiging matyaga tayo sa kanila. Amen po ba? Minsan napapaiyak nila tayo sa kanila mga biro. Pero pinagtsatsagaan natin sila. Kasi nga, no, naiintindihan natin na sila man is a process. Look at your neighbor and says, you are a process. Dapat ganun, ano? Kaya nga marinig mo. Alam mo, 25 years na Kristiyano na yan, pero bakit parang walang pagbabago? Sabihin mo, pagka may ganun kayong naririnig, kapatid, process din kasi siya. Kahit pastor yan, kahit pastor ako, process pa rin ako. Alam nyo ba yun? Ang mga pastor, akala nyo kasi, iba kasi yung, ay, pastor yan, talaga. May halo sa ulo. May halo, alam nyo yung halo, di ba? No, we are all in a process. Even Paul himself, he is a process. Sabi ko nga sa inyo, si Paul, many miracles was done in the life of Paul. Many vision was given to him by God, and yet he says that I'm still in a process. I have not yet obtained it. I move forward. I press on toward the goal that God calls me to do. Dapat meron tayong ganitong mentality, especially in this coming year. Ilang araw na lang, no? New year na. How many days na lang mag-new year na? May bago na naman tayong haharapin. If you view Christian growth as an instant experience, you're delivered once and for all from all the problems, then you got it all wrong. Kala nyo, pag naging Kristiyano kayo, lahat ng problema nyo, wala na, no. Nag-uumpisa pa lang, mga kapatid. But one good thing I want to tell you, when you came to know Christ, you are not alone anymore. Hallelujah. We are not alone anymore. That's why there is joy even though trials came to a Christian believer. That's why there is a smile in their face kahit na maraming problema, because you know that you're not alone. Emmanuel, God with us. That's the meaning of Christmas, right? Hindi na tayo nag-iisa. Nagiging Pasensyoso tayo sa mga bagay na pagtsatsagaan natin, na pagtatagumpayan natin ng mga bagay kahit alam natin hindi na tayo nag-iisa sa laban na ito. The not having a right attitude, Christian growth requires always moving ahead. Kung meron man tao, sabi ko nga sa inyo, na magsasabi nito, it could have been Paul. For the many miracles that he has, God used him, and then God has showed him many visions. But he said, I need to keep moving. Kailangan kong magpatuloy. Alam mo, kahit nandun na siya sa kulungan, he wrote a letter to Timothy, his son in the faith. He said, anak, pakidala mo naman yung coat ko rito kasi medyo malamig dito sa kulungan. At please, anak, pakidala mo rin yung mga parchments ko, yung kanyang mga, yung mga scripture noon, mga scrolls, gusto niyang pag-aralan. Imagine, Paul was already in prison and he knows he's going to die. Ikaw ba naman, mamamatay ka na lang, alam mo nang mamamatay ka, gusto mo pa lang mag-aral ng salita ng Diyos. That's how zealous Paul was in the Word of God. Tayo kasi, next year na lang ako mag-uumpisa mag-aral ulit, mag-study ng Bible, mag-read ng Bible. Kasi, ilang araw na lang naman eh. Isa na lang ako sa New Year. No, marami pa namang time. Pero Paul, you know, he was in prison. He's facing death. And yet, in 2 Timothy chapter 4, verse 13, he commanded Paul to bring his coat. And then he adds, his book, especially the parchments, he was facing execution, but he wanted his book so he could keep on growing. Imagine, mamamatay na lang si Paul, gusto niya pa rin mag-aral ng magsaliksik kung ano yung nais o yung gusto ng Diyos sa kanyang buhay. Paul's praise in Greek makes it more emphatic, but wanting Paul's single attitude of always moving ahead, meron itong tatlong ramification. First, an attitude of moving ahead from the past, leave it there, forgetting what lies behind. Ayan. No, tayo kasi, no, mga Kristiyano, kahit na Kristiyano na, pagka talagang tayo nasaktan, ang hirap nating magpatawad. No? I forgive him, but I cannot forget what he do. No? Okay. But I don't want to see him. I forgive him, but I don't want to see him. No? Ganun yung mentality ng kahit na Kristiyano na. But Paul says that we should have an attitude of moving ahead from the past. Leave it there. Forget what lies behind. Again, ito na naman yung picture na kung saan ang isang mananakbo, hindi naman tatakbo yan na. Tumatakbo siya na. Ano mangyari sa kanya? Babangga siya, di ba? He could fall, he could stumble when he runs na yung kanyang leeg ay nandun sa likuran. And that's why Paul says, leave it behind. Leave it there. Kasi may mga nagsasabi na, alam mo, yung gamitin mo yung mga nakaraan para magtagumpay ka, yung mga pang-aapi nila sa'yo. Talagang gamitin mo yun para ikaw ay para sila naman ang lungod sa'yo pagdating ng araw. Yun yung mga payo ng mga makamundo. It's not coming from the Word of God, by the way. Yes, there are instances that we need to look back. Parang pag nagdadrive ka, di ba? You just see, tingnan mo lang kung asaan ka na. Okay, ah, malayo-layo na pala yung aking nararating. Ah, okay. But always focus on the road ahead. There are times that we need to look back just to remind us of how God has done in our life. Amen? Alam niyo, nung tinawag tayo, nung 1 year, 2 years, and even sometimes, kahit bago pa lang, minsan naman kasi hindi talaga nakikita natin sa sarili natin. Kailangan may magsabing iba. Talaga bang may nagbago na sa akin? No, kagabi nagpapatotoo yung isang kapatid na yung isa niyang dating kasama sa trabaho na laging bulyaw ng bulyaw sa kanya, naging Kristiyano. At unti-unti napansin nila na yung kanyang pananalita naging mahinahon. Pero hindi niya nararamdaman. May ibang taong nagsabi, alam mo, laki na ng pinagbago mo. Wow! Diba? Minsan hindi natin nakikita eh. Kaya sometimes, mag-ano rin tayo na hanggang saan na ba ako? Saan na ba yung buhay Kristiyano ko? Nasaan na ba yung nilalakad ko? Gaano na ba kalalim yung pagkakilala ko sa Panginoong Jesus? From time to time, let us just look back and see where we're at and then where we are heading. Alam nyo, it can be helpful to reflect on what happened to us in the past in order to understand where we are at present and where we need to grow. Amen. There's a biblical case of self-examination, which means evaluating things that have happened in our past, both good and bad. Alam nyo lahat ng mabuti, kahit masamang bagay nangyari sa atin, merong aral yan. Naniniwala ba kayo ron?
Amen.
All things work together for good for them who love God and to them who are called according to His purpose. Kaya nga ngayon, harapin na naman natin ang 2019, di ba mga kapatid? Mag-move on na kayo, 2019 na. Sabi mo sa katabi mo, mag-move on ka na.
Mag-move na.
2019 na, ilang araw na lang. Don't live in the past, mga kapatid. Just forgive and forget. Kalimutan nyo na. Alam nyo kasi, yung pang nagpatawad ka lang, ano yan eh, parang uminom ka ng tubig. Ano yan? Intermission. Pero alam nyo yung nagpatawad ka, pero yung hindi ka nag-forget, hindi mo kinalimutan. Sa una yan, parang wala lang, no? Parang okay na, patawad ko naman na siya. I leave it all behind, yung mga sakit na nabinigay niya sa akin, okay na yun, tinatawad ko na siya. Pero hirap pa rin kalimutan eh. Sa una, hindi mo nararamdaman yan. Parang ganito yan, parang baso. Pag hawak-hawak mo yan, subukan mong hawakan to na isang oras. Tingnan ko kung hindi ka mangalay. It's the same thing of not forgetting. Okay? There are times na kung saan, akala mo talagang tunay na napatawad mo na yung tao. Akala mo, pero habang nagtatagal, pag nakita mo pala siya, hindi mo pa pala siya tunay na napatawad. You have to leave it all behind. Leave the glass down. No? Iwanan natin yung baso. That's what Amen. Means of true forgiveness and forgetting. Amen? That's an attitude of leaving all behind. And then he said, an attitude of moving ahead toward the future. Aim for the goal. Reaching forward to what lies ahead. In verse 13, Paul uses a term of describing a runner who stretches and strains every muscle as he runs towards the finish line, the upward call of God. Kakita na kayo ng mga tumatakbo, di ba? Talagang yung mga muscle niyan, in slow-mo, takita mo talagang nagbi-build up. It's the same thing Paul was using this analogy of a runner na kung saan he really ran towards that goal. Tumatakbo siya ng merong kalakasan, merong pagtsatsaga. Everything we do, how we conduct ourselves in our families and in public, how we spend time, our money, how we serve the Lord, should all be done with a mindset, I'm going to stand before the Lord and give an account someday, and I want to please Him. Dapat nandun yung ating attitude na always moving ahead. Number three of this, having an attitude of yung hindi pa tayo nararating, hindi pa natin nararating, an attitude of moving ahead in the present. Keep moving. Kanina, leaving all behind. Amen? And then, pangalawa, we are moving toward the future or aiming for that goal. Pangatlo, this is an attitude of the present. Keep moving. Pressing, continue to press towards the goal. Paul had a holy dissatisfaction where he was at. So he keep on pressing on. You know, Paul's letter to the Christian, kung mababasa niyo yung kanyang most of his letter, always an encouragement to move on, to press on toward the goal, to give a godly life, godliness, exercise godliness. Even Paul, yung si Timothy, Paul always instruct him to be godly. Dito pinapakita ni Paul na you should always be keep moving on. If God has dealt with something in your life, don't slip back into it again. If He has cleansed out a dirty closet of your life, don't start throwing the junk in there again. No, minsan kasi, yung kasalanan na dapat isinantabi na, pinatawad na, dininis ng Panginoon, minsan binabalik-balikan pa rin natin. Paul is saying, press on towards the goal. What is present? Keep moving. If you want to grow in the Lord, it's essential that you maintain a teachable heart. Examine yourself. If you stand in the faith, alam niyo yung kahalagahan of evaluating ourselves, especially this going year end, mag-ilang araw na lang sabi we're going. And even every companies, do you know every companies do inventories? Diba? We even do monthly inventories. Bakit natin ginagawang inventaryo? Why are we doing that? So that we know what our losses are. We know what we gain and we know where we're going. This is also the same in spiritual walk with God. Ano ba ang nagawa ko sa Panginoon this year? This whole 2018. Ano ba yung mga nagawa ko sa Panginoon? How did I serve God? With my personal life, did I walk pleasing? Naging pleasing ba ang buhay ko sa Panginoon? Marami bang napagpala sa buhay ko sa Panginoon? That's your personal. Then, in a corporate, what did I do? Ano ba yung nagawa ko para sa church? Naging tapat ba ako sa pagbibigay ko para ang gawain ng Panginoon ay lumagupa? These are the things that we need to evaluate in our life as we go on, as we press on forward this 2019. I know most of you have goals, no? Marami sa atin nagpaplano ng umuwi. So what are you planning to do? Hindi, bahala na ang Diyos, uwi na ako. Yes, that's good. We bring it to God, all our plans, but we pray, we ask for guidance, but we also plan. We do effort, right? Amen, amen po?
Amen.
If you want to grow in the Lord, as sabi ko nga, it's essential that you maintain a teachable heart. A teachable heart is humble, first of all, because he admits, I might be wrong or lacking in understanding, I may need to repent and change. A teachable heart is submissive, ready to respond to a new light God gives him from his word. A person with a teachable heart is not know-it-all, refusing to learn from other Christians. With that kind of teachable heart, keep moving in the present. Marami kasing Christian, hindi, alam ko na yan. O, alam ko na yan. Napakaralan na namin yan eh, sa Christian 101, sa Christian 201. No, but I admire those Christians na kahit na napag-aralan na nila, no, I admire them. I will sit down kasi may bagong revelation. I admire because they want to grow. Amen?
Amen.
And admire actually some churches na kung saan yung kanilang mga leaders pinupush o ini-encourage ng kanilang pastors na to join those new believers in the training. Kahit nakakuha na ng Alpha, they will sit down just to encourage a new believer. Kahit nakapag-LG training na, join them. Alam mo, laking encouragement yun sa mga bago. Na kahit na, hindi kasi, tapos na ako dyan, hindi may gagawin pa ako. Ganun yung mentality ng maraming Kristiyano eh. But you know what? I admire those Christians in which I still want to take this, kahit nakuha ko na to doon, I want to take this. I admire that because they want to grow. It's part of our growing. There are new revelation in God's word, and even when we read the word, kaya nga pinauulit-ulit natin yan. How many times I read the word of God from Genesis to Revelation, but there is always fresh revelation from the word of God. Amen. Hindi dahil sa we know it all things. No, we're not. Even pastors don't know everything, and that's why we need to study. We need to research new books, read new books, go to Christian sites and learn more and more. There's one preacher, he says that, may nagtanong sa kanya, sabi niya, if you will be allowed to live again, what would you do? And he said, I will study the Word of God. Yun ang sabi niya, just like Paul. Even to the time or to the point of his execution, he's still studying the Word of God. Number three, and my last point is that, to grow as a Christian, you got to give it the proper effort. You have to give it the proper effort. We need the balance of God's word here. God is sovereign and we don't need to do anything. Yan yung sabi ng iba. It's all up to us. Scripture says that God is at work in you, so work with God. We work with God, not with our own self. The Christian life is an active cooperation with the sovereign God. Again, an analogy of a runner race, he cannot afford to view the scenery, no? Yung pagka tumatakbo yung isang runner sa marathon, wow, daming tao, kakaway-kaway siya habang tumatakbo siya, no? Hindi pwedeng ganun. Hindi tayo nadidistract doon sa mga sa worldly things. I'm talking about worldly things. When a Christian run the race which God has called him to do, his eye should be fixed on the goal, on the prize, not on the worldly materials, not on the things, because the world, sabi ng John, no, 1 John chapter 2, 15 to 17, If anyone loves the world and everything in the world, the love of the Father is not in him. Yun yung sinasabi ng Panginoon. That's why we leave aside, we should not be distracted with by the world's sceneries, and our eyes should be fixed on what we are running for or what we are aiming for. The question that each of us need to answer is this: do I devote myself to knowing Christ this coming year? Ano ba yung plano natin this year? Ano ba yung gusto natin gawin this year to achieve that spiritual maturity? Because hindi natin pwedeng sabihin na I will just go along with the flow, no? And as I said, we always preach and teach you, read your word, read the Bible daily, meditate on them daily. Now to look back at our last years, ano ba yung mga bagay na nakikita natin na kung saan needs improvement? No? What or where, in which area of my life do I need to improve? Do I need to lessen? Do I need to lessen my time in Facebook, my time in movies, my time in these things that is making me or hindering my growth in Christ? Then let's do so. Do it. If we want to really grow spiritually, and by the way, a brethren can discern you if you are growing. Nadidiscern yan ng isang kapatid na mature. It's not about a matter whether you are 30 years, 40 years as a Christian, but without making this proper effort, without making this goal or pressing on towards the goal in which Christ has called us to do, you will never grow as Christian. Kung sasabihin mo pa rin na you are still doing the same things that you are doing for the last year, you need to change in character. We need to change in attitude. We need to change the way we treat people. We need to change how we treat our job, yung ating mga trabaho. We need to give it a proper effort. It's not about only when it's convenient na tayo'y pupunta, na tayo'y dadalo. You know what God honors? Sacrifice. Remember that Lord Jesus Christ commended that woman, that very poor woman who put 2 copper coins on the box. The rest of the people put plenty, big amount of money. But the Lord says, you know what? They give out of their abundance. But this poor widow gave all that she had. And Christ commended that woman for what she done. There are things in life that is hard to do. There are mga bagay tayong hirap alisin, but we need to remove it. We need to change in our attitude if we want to grow in Christ. This coming 2019, we should aim for the highest call of God in our life. Let's move on. Let's press on toward the goal. Iwanan na natin yung mga pain. No? This year, you know what's beautiful with the Lord? God is a God of many chances. Amen. Amen. Hindi lang siya one chance. Many, many chances. Patuloy tayong binibigyan ng pagkakataon. Ngayon, wow, new year na naman. Sa one, ito naman, bagong chance, bagong pakikibaka, bagong challenges in life. Aren't we excited? God has given us, we reached 2019. Amen.
Yes, amen.
Maraming mga kapatiran, yung kanilang mga magulang, 2 of our brethren, their parents passed away. We thank God for our parents. We thank God for our life. Patuloy natin pinasasalamatan ng Panginoon sa bagong buhay. Ngayon, 2019, what are your plans to grow in Christ? I heard about a mountain climber and I want to end here. A mountain climber, you know yung mahilig umakyat sa Mount Everest. On his epitaph, alam nyo yung epitaph, yun sa kanyang puntod, ang nakalagay doon, he died climbing. You know, it should be in every Christian's mindset. It should be true to Christians to remember that God just did not put us in the playground. No, God, when God called us, He put us in the battleground. It's not always gonna be easy, as I told you, my brethren. There are many challenges, trials to face. This coming 2019, there will be challenges, there will be trials, there will be problems. But as we press on toward that goal, andun yung prize, andun yung prize. All those trials, all those yung mga bagay na nagpapahirap sa atin, if our eyes are fixed, kaya nga sabi ni Paul, fix on your eyes on the things that are above. For the things that are above are eternal. The things that are here are all temporary. Even your trials are for temporary, the Lord Jesus Christ says. Panandalian lang ang mga pagsubok, mga kapatid. But if we face, we focus our eyes on the Lord Jesus Christ, katulad ng ginagawa ni Paul, even death could not stop us. Hallelujah. That should be our aim this coming year, 2019. Running the race is not always easy, as I told you. There will be humps. There will be hills. There will be mountains. There will be hindrance. But Jesus Christ already won that for us. All we need to do is to run the race. Look at your neighbor and says, run the race.
Run the race.
Run the race.
Run the race.
If you want to grow as Christian, make sure you are in the race. Ulitin ko, no? If you want to grow as a Christian, be sure you have registered on the right race. Baka mali ang tinatakbuhan mo, kapatid. Be sure that Christ has laid hold of your life, that you are saved, you have accepted Christ as your Lord and personal Savior. And you allow Christ to continue to work in you, change you, change your attitude, change your heart, change your perspective. Make sure you have the right attitude in dealing with all these things. That you have that attitude na, well, natutunan ko na yan, alam ko na yan, that we haven't arrived yet. But we continue to desire to learn, to train. Pag may mga training, sama ko dyan, sali ako dyan. Dapat ganun po yung ating mga mentality. may evangelism training, di, alam ko na yan, it's all the same. No, we should go there. This year, there will be challenges for every one of us. Christian walk is a lifelong process. We should have that mentality para hindi po tayo napapagod agad. Slowly, sabi nga, but surely. Give it a proper effort. Focus on the goal of being like Christ. This year, 2019. I cannot check or hindi ko alam kung ano yung mga dapat yung iwanan. It is only God who knows. Can we bow down our head? Heavenly Father, we thank you, Lord, for the last year of 2018. Thank you, Lord, that you have brought us, Lord, to this new year. There will be new challenges. There will be new trials. But we thank you because, Lord, we are encouraged to move on, to press on toward the goal of the upright call of God for our life. Father, I pray. Lord, I pray that even as we go to this new year, magkaroon kami ng right attitude in facing the new year, O Lord God. Magkaroon kami ng proper perspective on life, O Lord God, na magpatuloy kahit na mahirap, magpatuloy sa takbuhin, itinalaga mo, Panginoon, tapusin, Panginoon, yung takbuhin, never to quit, O Lord God, but to continue, to persevere, O Lord God, to run the race. And Lord, tulad ng sinabi mo sa iyong salita, we set aside all anxieties, we set aside all the sin that easily entangle us, O Lord God, but we continue to run the race with perseverance, O Lord God, with determination, with an attitude, Lord God, that we will not get tired. Lord, it's my prayer to all of us. Kasama ako, Panginoon, na patuloy kaming tumakbo sa takbuhin. Tinalaga mo, kailangan namin ang iyong kalakasan. Sa araw-araw, kailangan namin ang banal na Espiritu na continue to lead us and guide us to live a holy life, O Lord God, that is pleasing to you this coming 2019. Lord, I pray, O Lord God, that you will raise up, Lord God, diligent workers in this church to fulfill, O Lord God, your plan for this church. Father, I thank you for this message, Lord. I thank you for this message, O God. Father, we praise you and we thank you sapagkat ikaw ang nagturo sa amin sa araw na ito. Purihin ka, Ama, sa pangalan ng Jesus, ito pong aking dalangin. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen.